There are three functions in DAX to compute the number of values in a column that are not blank. They are COUNT, COUNTA, and COUNTX. There are no differences at all between COUNT and COUNTA. That's why we only cover COUNT and COUNTX. Besides, COUNT is nothing but the short version of COUNTX. You can use COUNT whenever you need to count the number of rows with a value and the expression you use is just one column from the model. Let's see some code. The first calculation, number of customers, counts the number of customers. In Asia, we have 3658 customers. By using COUNT over customer name, we are counting the number of customers that actually have a name, where the name is not blank. And of course, the number is slightly smaller. You can obtain the very same expression if you use COUNTX over customer of customer name, because in this case, the formula we are using contains only one column. Therefore, COUNT and COUNTX, they provide the same result. You can also obtain the same calculation using a bit longer expression that relies on calculate. That does a calculate of COUNT rows of customers where the customer name is not blank. The result is totally identical, and the code is a bit longer. Being longer in this case is not bad, because it is a bit more clear what are the intentions of the developer, which is counting the number of customers where the name is not blank. So we slightly prefer the version with calculate to the version with count, that despite being shorter, it is a bit harder to read and understand. You need to use COUNTX instead of COUNT whenever you want to count the number of expressions that do not lead to a blank. In this example, I'm using COUNTX over customers, so I'm iterating over customers, and I'm counting the number of rows where the result of this division is not a blank. This division has no special meaning. The only reason we are using it is because sometimes this returns a blank, so it provides some number. COUNTX over customers provides 3203, which is the number of customers where this division is not a blank. If you need to count the number of non-blank expression, then in this case, COUNTX reads a bit better. If you compare it with the calculate version, that would be definitely too long. Nevertheless, you can obtain the same result using a count rows over a filter. This count rows counts the number of rows of the result of filter, where filter is filtering customers, where the result of the expression is not a blank. Again, the code is a bit longer, but it is a bit easier to understand the intention of the developer. Moreover, you need to pay attention to the strings, because when you count numbers, so you're using COUNT over an expression that returns a number, then the only values which are not counted are the blanks. But in the very special case of strings, there is a different behavior between empty strings and blanks. COUNT does not count blanks, but it counts empty strings. Let's say that with an example. First, I have the count of customer names. Then I created another calculation that uses count rows of customers, removing only the blanks. And the third calculation removes the empty strings. As you see from the result, COUNT and COUNT no blanks, they produce the very same result. Whereas the version that does not count empty strings provides a different number. COUNT considers in a different way blanks and empty strings. Again, this is a good reason why we prefer the version with calculate. If you rely on COUNT, you always need to remember the special behavior with empty strings. Whereas if you write the longer version that is using calculate, then it will be easier to understand exactly what you are counting by simply looking at the code.